Hey guys, SBM here, and today we're doing the second gym. Nice. Yeah, before we start off, ignoring me switching around Pokemon, I had to speed up some of the battles in the gym so I could fit the whole gym and the leader in one video, which from now on I might start doing them in separate videos, depending, because then you can see the gym leader at normal speed. Don't worry, Bugs is at normal speed, but all his subordinates aren't. So yeah, there's these spiders, and if you want to battle all the trainers, the first one you go on is the middle one. And if there's a path it can take, it will. So it's not going to skip a path unless it's not taut. Do I mean taut? Under tension. I don't know. So anyway, we come up to the battle guy, and we end up going up to like 4 times speed. No. 2 times speed is 1 times faster. Yeah, 4 times speed, so basically that's why the sound keeps glitching out. So he leaves with Cap, hey, and he burns it, because that's what Annie does. He leaves with another, he brings that wheel, and he destroys it with Ember, because that's what Annie does. And Annie turns to level 16, and tries to learn Dragon Rage, which is quite awesome. Because look how much HP Annie's got. Oh wait, sorry, shut up. Yay! Annie evolved! So we now have a Charmeleon. Awesome. Anyway, as I was saying, Annie has only like just over 40, well she had only just over 40 before she evolved. So Dragon Rage is a really useful move at this time. So yeah, I switched around my Pokemon, so... Wait, who did I bring out? Okay, I brought out Jimmy, but then I started switching back for Tom. So yeah, you've got to spend the long time it takes for you to work all the way back to the beginning. Which we do. And then we take the other one on the left, which will take us to the proceeding point. If you take the one on the right, then you'll just get stuck on that dead end. So we've got our next train here, which is also going to make 4 times speed, because I fail at keeping track of time. So he leads to the level 7 wheel. And I throughout this whole battle, I forget I had Quick Attack. If I had remembered I had Quick Attack, this battle would have been so much easier. Especially when it gets onto one of the later Pokemon. So yeah, I kill Weedle. And eventually, kill Kuna. Eventually. And then he brings out a level 12 Beedrill. Which if I had remembered Quick Attack, this would have been over a lot quicker. Lol. Anyway, he keeps using Fury Attack, which every time it hits does 3 damage to me, and like, he doesn't die from last pound, and I'm like, no, don't die, don't die, and I'll survive with 2 HP and kill it, which is just awesome. I feel like Annie talking like 50 million miles now. So I'm trying to learn something that I think is Pursuit. It's a dark move that does 40 damage. And then, twice in one video. Tom evolves into Grovyle, so that's 2 evolutions in one video, which is quite awesome. So yeah, then I was going to take forever trying to learn what I thought was Leaf Blade, but actually wasn't, because it turned out to be Fury Cutter, which kind of sucks, so I skipped that. I didn't want to learn Fury Cutter. Quick trip to Pokemon Center later and switch on to Pokemon, and we're ready to proceed. Now I really should have dropped the blue wire first to fight that bug catcher, but instead I ended up having to come over here and fight the twins. I think in the original they're called May and Amy, or was that a different pair of twins? Anyway, this is like the first proper double battle in the game. So he has Ladybird and Spinarak, I have Jimmy and Dave. Jimmy uses Spinarak, Dave uses Thundershock and Ladybird dies. He uses Poison Sting, doesn't kill me thank god. And then I kill it with Bite or Thundershock. That battle was too quick. Yeah. Mental note to self, don't put battles at times 4 speed, because otherwise you lose track of what's happening. So yeah, we go back here, flip the blue switch to make the rope go lax. No. Floppy. No. That seems to be competition. Not tight. No. Anyway, we battle this other guy. He's only got one Pokemon, it's Paris, level 13. And we leave with Jimmy. We use bite, and we get done in by a Fex Ball, which lucky he didn't poison it. So it's all good. And I couldn't be bothered to go all the way back to the Pokemon Center, so I skipped the point of me using a poison, paralyzed heal. So we go over to where the twins were again, deactivate the blue switch, come back and deactivate the red switch, eventually, which means we can get to Bugsy! Yay! By the way, light yellow liquid equals poison, and dark equals paralyzed, I think. I know blue's awakening, but that's the point. So now, we're about to face the second gym leader, Bugsy. So he leads with the Scyther, which is kind of gay, because that used to be his last Pokemon, and in fact it's his best Pokemon. So I've done Shock, and it doesn't die or paralyze, it's gay. So it uses its Aurum Berry, I think it was, and it uses Quick Attack, it does nothing to me. I use Sunshock again, and for some reason it doesn't die, I didn't actually see why. So then he uses some kind of potion. It leers me. It leaves me again. I Thundershock it. It doesn't die. And it U-turns and does a massive amount of damage. And that was important because I knew I couldn't stay in that. But I also knew that Metapod wouldn't be able to kill me. And I stupidly can't remember where Sonic Boom is on my setlist, having only ever used Thundershock. And where that have Supersonic, which is quite cool. And I think we just tackle. So I switch out to my HM slave, Rattata, who's actually ironically one of my strongest Pokemon, but I've never used him, for the sheer fact that I could heal up Dave. But stupidly, I used my potion on the wrong Pokemon. I know. Shocking. So now I use it on the correct Pokemon, which means a pair there. He U-turns me, which kills Rattata, which means Dave's going to get all the experience for killing Scyther. He brings out Kuna. And I bring out Jimmy, because Jimmy's like the only Pokemon that can evolve soon that hasn't. So he's poisoning, I'm like, don't get poisoned, and he gets poisoned, because it's gay. So yeah, I Water Gun, and it's 3-8 KO, he poisons me again, I get hurt by poison, and I kill it with Water Gun, and the world, once again, the day is saved, thanks to Jimmy the Totodile. No, don't go there. I turn to level 16, and I switch out for Dave, because Dave's the one that's going to get all the experience from Scyther, because that's what Dave does. So he uses Focus NJ, I use Pound. Yeah, I need to actually label what moves we're talking about. So I use Supersonic to get confusion on it. It U-turns me. Nearly kills me. I Thundershock. And it dies. And we just beat the second gym leader. Bum bum. So yeah, Bugs is like, you're quite a good trainer. Have a hive badge. We're like, we just got the hive badge. Do 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 do. And then he also eventually gives us... Oh, he tells us that we can use Quite Outside of Battle and raise up Pokemon 30. Nice. And he gives us U-turn, which is actually quite a decent move, but shouldn't be wasted in-game. So yeah, we flick the blue switch so we can get out quicker. Hop onto the Spinarak train. Weep, weep. I could have cut so much of this out, seeing how much time's left. So yeah, we ride the other spinner train back, we exit the gym. Why have we stopped? There we go. We exit the gym. That's it. Jimmy survives with 1 HP, because that's how the new poison stuff works, which is quite a good idea. We get a phone call, which we ignore, because that's what we do. We ignore phone calls, unless the ones we can't avoid. And that's the end of the video, bye!